Hello and welcome to BrushMyQuant channel. If you wish to receive continuous updates from us, then consider subscribing to the channel by clicking on the subscribe icon to the right bottom of this screen. So let's get started with today's topic of work rate problems. So we will start with rate, time and work concept. Then we'll see what happens when work done is in parts. Then work done when people are working together, filling and emptying a tank, specifically inlet and outlet pipe problems, and then we'll look into some of the solved problems. Let's start with rate, time and work concept. All the problems in this topic are based on a very simple formula, which is rate into time is equal to work done. Let's take an example. So for me to record this video, it will take around 20 to 30 minutes. Let's assume it is 30 minutes. So my rate multiplied by the time taken, which is 30 minutes, is equal to work done, which is completing this video. So that is how we calculate the work done by multiplying the rate of a particular person or a particular machine multiplied by the time they are taking to complete that particular work. Now, if the work done is same throughout the problem, then the work done can very well be taken as one. Let's take an example to understand this. So it takes Ram 5 days to paint a house, and it takes Shyam 10 days to paint the same house. Since we are talking about the same work done by both of them, which is nothing but painting a house, so we can very well take the work done as one in this case. Now, what happens when work done is actually in parts or in quantities? So if work done is in parts, such as 20 houses painted or 25 houses painted, then the work done can very well be taken as 20 and 25 respectively. Let's take an example. So Rohan takes 10 minutes to read 20 pages and Mohan takes 15 minutes to read 30 pages. So in case of Rohan, we can take the work done as 20 pages. And in case of Mohan, we can take the work done as 30 pages. Now, what happens when people work together? So when two people work together, then their combined rate becomes sum of their rates. Example, let's say R1 is the rate of the first person working alone. R2 is the rate of the second person working alone. And if both of them are working together, then the combined rate becomes R1 plus R2. So if there are 10 people working together, each of them has a rate of R1, then the combined rate of 10 people working together will become 10 into R1. Which is nothing but adding R1 10 times. Let's take an example. So it takes 7 machines working together 7 days to print 7 books. So in this case, if rate of one machine is R, then rate of 7 machines will become 7 into R because all of them have the same rate and they are working together. Now let's see filling and emptying a tank, specifically inlet and outlet pipe problems. How do we solve those kind of problems? So let's start with filling a tank. Now, whenever we are dealing with problems involving filling a tank, then inlet pipe, the pipe which is actually going to fill water inside the tank, will always do a positive work to fill the tank. That means as the pipe is starting the work, the overall water or whatever liquid the pipe is filling in the tank will start increasing. The outlet pipe, on the other hand, will do a negative work to empty the tank, right? Because outlet pipe is taking out the liquid. So it will reduce the overall work done by the inlet pipe. So the inlet pipe's work will increase if both the pipes are open together. So in this kind of problems, we will take the work done by the inlet pipe as a positive work and subtract the work done by the outlet pipe because it is going to empty the tank, and then calculate the total work done, which will be nothing but equal to the capacity of the tank. Now, what happens when we are trying to empty a tank? Then the scenario reverses. Then your inlet pipe will do a negative work to fill the tank because we are supposed to empty the tank. The outlet pipe will do a positive work to empty the tank because we are emptying the tank. And the inlet pipe in this case will increase the work to be done by the outlet pipe. So in this kind of problems, outlet pipe will do a positive work because we have to empty the tank. inlet pipe will do a negative work. So we have to subtract the work done by the inlet pipe from the work done by the outlet pipe to get the overall work done. And the overall work done will be nothing but equal to the capacity of the tank. Now let's solve some problems to understand all these concepts a bit better. You can pause the video and give it a shot. I hope you were able to solve the problem, but anyways, let's try to solve it together. So it takes 7 machines, 7 days to print 7 books. How much time will it take 10 machines to print 10 books? So let's say rate of one machine is R. So rate of 7 machines will become 7R. So using the formula rate multiplied by time is equal to work done. The overall rate is 7R multiplied by the time, which is 7 days, is equal to work done, which is nothing but 7 books. If we solve this, we will get the value of R as 1 by 7. That means rate of each machine is equal to 1 by 7. Now, when it comes to 10 machines, their rate will become 10R multiplied by the time taken, which is what we need to find, is equal to work done, which is 10. That means the time will be nothing but 1 divided by R, or 1 divided by 7, or nothing but 7 days. Let's try more problems. Again, you can pause the video and resume it once you are done. Hope you were able to solve the problem. It takes Ram 5 days to paint a house. It takes Shyam 10 days to paint the same house. How much time will it take both to work together and paint the same house? So let's solve for Ram first. Let's say rate of Ram is R. So rate multiplied by time taken, which is 5, is equal to work done, which is painting a house. So let's say the work done is 1. That means rate of Ram is nothing but 1 divided by 5. Let's solve for Shyam. So let's say rate of Shyam is S multiplied by the time taken, which is 10 days, is equal to work done, which is 1. That means rate of Shyam becomes 1 by 10. Now, when both of them are working together, then their combined rates will be nothing but sum of their rates, which is nothing but 1 by 5 plus 1 by 10, which is 2 by 10 plus 1 by 10, or nothing but 3 by 10. So rate multiplied by the time taken, which is what we have to find, is equal to work done. That means if they are working together, then they are going to take around 10 divided by 3 days, which is nothing but around 3.33 days. Let's try more problems. Again, you can pause the video and give it a shot. Hope you were able to solve the problem. So Rohan takes 10 minutes to read 20 pages. Mohan takes 15 minutes to read 30 pages. Then how many pages can both of them read together in 30 minutes? So let's solve for Rohan first. So let's say rate of Rohan is R multiplied by the time taken, which is 10, is equal to work done, which is 20 pages. That means Rohan can read 2 pages per minute. Let's solve for Mohan. So rate of Mohan is M multiplied by the time taken, which is 15 minutes, is equal to 30 pages. That means rate of Mohan is also 2 pages per minute. If they both are working together, then the combined rate becomes R plus N, which is 2 plus 2, multiplied by time taken, which is 30 minutes, is equal to number of pages, which is nothing but 4 multiplied by 30, or 120 pages. You can pause the video and give it a shot. Hope you were able to solve the problem. So if 15 men work together, can finish the work in 20 days. Let's say rate of one man is M. So rate of 15 men becomes 15M multiplied by 20 is equal to work done. Let's say work done is 1. That means rate of one man becomes 1 divided by 300. 10 women working together can finish the same work in the same number of days as 15 men. So let's say rate of one woman is W. So rate of 10 women becomes 10W multiplied by the same time, which is 20 days, is equal to work done, which is 1. That means rate of each woman becomes 1 divided by 200. Now we need to find how many days will it take one man and one woman working together to complete the same work. So if they are working together, their rates will be nothing but sum of their rates, which is M plus W, which is 1 divided by 300 plus 1 divided by 200. And this becomes 2 by 600 plus 3 by 600 or nothing but 5 by 600 or 1 by 120. That means rate multiplied by the time taken, which is what we need to find, is equal to work done, which is 1. That means the time taken will be nothing but 120 days. Let's solve a problem on inlet and outlet pipes. You can pause the video and give it a shot. Hope you were able to solve the problem. So an inlet pipe can fill an empty tank in 4 hours. So let's say rate of inlet pipe is I multiplied by the time taken, which is 4, is equal to work done, which is the capacity of the tank. Since we are talking about the same tank, so we can take the capacity of the tank as 1. That means rate of the inlet pipe is 1 divided by 4. An outlet pipe can empty the same tank in 10 hours. So let's say outlet pipe's rate is O multiplied by the time taken 10 is equal to 1. That means rate of outlet pipe is 1 divided by 10. Now, if both the pipes are open together, then how much time will it take to fill an empty tank? Now, since we are filling an empty tank, so the inlet pipe is going to do a positive work and outlet pipe is going to do a negative work. So we have to take rate of the inlet pipe and subtract rate of the outlet pipe from that to get the overall rate multiplied by the time taken, which is what we need to find, is equal to work done. This becomes 5 by 20 minus 2 by 20 multiplied by T is equal to 1 implies T is equal to 20 by 3 hours. Hope you were able to understand the concept of work rate problems and able to solve all the problems which we solved together. If you found this video useful, please go ahead, like the video, provide your valuable comments. Do share the video with your friends and consider subscribing to the channel to get regular updates from us. Thank you for watching the video.